So here we are in Belgrade, commemorating the 10th anniversary of the beginning of the NATO bombing of Yugoslavia. And that bombing took place just before the 50th anniversary of NATO. And one of the reasons, in fact, in my opinion, principal reason for the bombing was in order to bring NATO into the U.S. concept of its new mission of military operations outside the defense perimeter of NATO, to transform NATO, which was theoretically in the beginning a defensive alliance against the supposed Soviet threat, to transform that NATO alliance into an instrument of intervention in the rest of the world. And the pretext for that was humanitarian necessity. So they had to set up a situation which they could say, we have to go save people, and this would be the excuse for NATO to do what it, which had never been part of the Atlantic Treaty, which is to bomb a sovereign state which had not threatened anybody, and ignoring the United Nations, in other words, ignoring international law, transforming NATO into an aggressive alliance. And of course, as historically common in the case of aggressions of this nature, the pretext was, we're doing this for the good of the people we're bombing. And in particular, we're doing this to save what they call the Kosovar at the time, meaning a particular group of Albanian secessionists in the Serbian province of Kosovo, and who happened to be, gangsters, and various questionable people that were armed and encouraged by the United States, the CIA, and British, not the British, the German secret services, who were secessionists. And who had engaged in provocations against the Yugoslav authorities, and the Yugoslav authorities responded to these provocations. I mean to say assassinations. They had been assassinating policemen and other Albanian Kosovars who didn't agree with them. They had engaged in this kind of activity, and predictably, the Yugoslav authorities had cracked down on them rather tough. Nothing compared to the way the United And this was translated as a humanitarian crisis, and we have to save people, etc. So this was staged, and the cameras were there to photograph the Albanians who went across the border, which was quite close to their relatives, a few miles away. And this was presented as deportation or something like that, when, in fact, of course, as soon as the bombing is, they rush back home and started throwing out the Serbs. So here we are, 10 years later, and getting ready for another NATO anniversary, the 60th this time, which is going to be very interesting because they're going to celebrate it in Strasbourg and the city across the Rhine from Strasbourg in Germany, Kiel. And they're locking up the inhabitants in order to celebrate this event. The citizens of Strasbourg and Kiel, and also Baden-Baden, which is nearby, have been given notice that they are not to leave their homes during this great event. Because somehow or other, if they left their homes, this might be a threat to the visiting heads of state, who will be supported by armies and helicopters and so on. I mean, if somebody there is seriously ill, they can have a police escort to go to the hospital. But other than that, people are to stay at home and enjoy from their home the fact that they are protected as part of this free world. And so meanwhile, Serbia is also protected as part of this free world. And it's a very sad situation, I must say, being here, because of course some of us are here and we meet people who have not been completely brainwashed, but this is a defeated country, and it's very sad to see, because this was a country that had a special tradition of independence and independence thinking. It was the only place in Europe that was part of the non-aligned movement in solidarity with the Third World during the Cold War. It was on either side of the Cold War. It pursued peaceful relations with India and Arab countries and the Third World generally. And it had its own version of socialism, which wasn't perfect, but it was an experiment that was interesting. And this was enough for it to be unnatural once the Soviet Union collapsed and the Soviet bloc collapsed. Well, then the United States saw that it wanted to, of course, to impose its system, which meant privatization of everything, to the whole of Europe. And so Yugoslavia was was an exception. And I don't like exceptions because exceptions might be experiments and something that might have show people that there's another way to do things that might be interesting, and particularly also to have good relations with Arab countries, for instance. And Yugoslavia had excellent relations with Arab countries, and you see some trace of that because it's interesting that with this the United States has violating all kinds of international agreements. Never mind about that. I mean, they just make, they made an agreement to safeguard the territorial integrity of Yugoslavia, but then if they carve Kosovo out and say it's independent. But it's very interesting that only 50 of the nearly 200 UN members have recognized Kosovo, and that's most of the European Union, but not even all of the European Union, and then some little island somewhere where somebody's given some money to somebody. Yeah, we all recognize Kosovo, whatever that is. I mean, you know, you don't want to start arguing at the war. But the fact, what's interesting is, for instance, despite all of the propaganda presenting the Serbs as being the anti-Muslim, the Muslim countries and the Arab countries have not recognized Kosovo because I think they understand that this is all an exercise in U.S. imperialism. And the whole charade of humanitarian intervention here has made a troubled situation vastly worse, created endless problems. The Serbs here are afraid that their country is going to be carved apart even more because there are movements being supported by outside questionably to detach even more territory from Serbia, because the real project has been here to destroy a country, to kill a country, to kill even the soul of a country, because Serbia was the part of Yugoslavia that held it together. It was the part that had been the core of the country to start with. All of the other secessionist groups were supported because they were destructive and because they would help destroy this